Nobody has ever asked me to talk on a subject like this. I must have talked about terrorism, I think, all my life I've been talking. I was graduated in the field of terrorism at very early in my life. I think it was a different form of terrorism, it was an insurgency. But it was an insurgency. I worked in Northeast for about 7 years, which included the integration of Sikkim before I went to Pakistan. And thereafter, from the Northeast, then Pakistan also is almost same, then I became head of operations and remained as head of operations. So except a brief period of time when I was not dealing with terrorism or Pakistan or espionage or counter-espionage, that basically an operational man does sabotage, subversion and espionage. These are the three areas of operations. I have been involved with this, but I have never talked on a subject like this, and I'll tell you why. But let me tell you a small incident. It was in November 2004, or maybe October or November 2004. New government had come. I was the chief of intelligence. So a proposal came that, well, let us withdraw the Prevention of Terrorism Act. There was an act in the country which was made because we were bound by a UN resolution 1373, of which we were a signatory, that we will make amends in our domestic laws in consonance with the internationally accepted UN Convention 1373. That was one factor. The another factor was this, that India was the biggest victim of terrorism. So we had suffered at that point of time, about 120,000 people died because of terrorism. That included Punjab and Kashmir and other parts of the country. So I went to the senior political leadership, the senior most political leadership, and I said, sir, it's a much serious matter. It's a strategic threat to the country. So let us not try to make it a political issue just because the previous government had enacted a law of Prevention of Terrorism Act. It is our international obligation. It is our internal responsibility. You cannot say that in this country terrorism is not an offense. What terrorists do can be an offense. It can be a murder. It can be a violation of Arms Act. It can be a violation of Explosives Act. But terrorism per se is not an offense. And this is the only act in this country which makes terrorism as an offense. So the response was that, well, I don't think that it is a strategic threat. And moreover, even if it is, we in our manifesto, we are committed to it. So I said, the manifestos do not take precedence over the country's long-term national interests. So I came back and I had another senior colleague within the government, Mani Dixit, who was the national security advisor. So I told him, I said, I had a meeting at the political leadership level, I'm quite this thing. So let us go together, try to convince. So he says, no, no, Ajit, don't do that. I will go separately, you don't tell him that we have met. So that it will have a greater impact. He will think that independently everybody is telling like that. So I said, yes, that also is a good idea. He said, you go, and the Home Secretary was another friend of mine, Anil Bajal, who is still here. He said, you go and talk to him also, that let him also go and talk separately to the Home Minister, and then everybody will be, once he gets it from many sides, probably there will be a change. So I think after a day or two, the National Security Advisor also met. And he said, yes, the same thing. He says, yes, it might be a security threat, so what? It is written in our manifesto that we will do it. I said, how can a top political leader think that even if the nation goes to hell, it's a political necessity for us? And the same thing was with Mr. Anil Bajal's. And then in December 2004, this country's Prevention of Terrorism Act, popularly known as POTA, was withdrawn. And from that day till today, there is no act which prescribes or punishes or makes it culpable to be a member of a terrorist organization. So I was quite happy when you said that speak on India's strategic response to terrorism, because it presupposes one thing, that terrorism is a strategic threat. Then only a question of strategic response comes. Because you diagnose a thing that the sore throat is not a sore throat, it is a cancer. And then you are treating the cancer. But so far the problem is to convince the people that it is a cancer. And then they only say, take some tulsi ki chai or something like that, and that will cure it. So the first thing about the India's strategic response is to realize, understand, and admit that it is a strategic threat.